Distinguished invitees, good afternoon. On behalf of the Vice Chancellor, I welcome you all back to the Defence Plenary Session number 2 of the KDU International Research Conference 2015 on the theme Inculcating Professionalism in Defence for National Development. It's my pleasure to introduce the chairperson of this session, Honorable HMGS Palihakkara, the Governor, Southern Province, Sri Lanka, to this august audience. Mr. HMGS Palihakkara was an illustrious and reputed civil servant and a diplomat who relishes 47 years of government, civil and diplomatic service. Born in 1947, he has obtained his bachelor's degree from then University of Ceylon, Peradeniya, with honours in 1968 and had joined the public service in 1969. Later, he joined Sri Lanka Foreign Service in 1979, where he served until his retirement, finally holding the mantle of Foreign Secretary for 3 years. During his illustrious diplomatic career, Mr. Palihakkara has been Sri Lanka Ambassador to Thailand, Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam, and Permanent Representative to Economic and Social Commission for Asia and Pacific, ESCAP, Bangkok. Furthering his diplomatic career, Mr. Palihakkara served as Sri Lanka's Ambassador and Permanent Representative to United Nations in Geneva and the leader of Sri Lanka delegation to the UN Human Rights Commission and the Conference on Disarmament, the only UN multilateral negotiating body on international arms control and security matters from 1997 to 2000. Mr. Palihakkara has been the Sri Lankan permanent representative to the United Nations, New York, from July 2008 to September 2009, and later was the chairman of UN Secretary General's Advisory Board on Disarmament Matters and Board of Trustees of United Nations Institute for Disarmament Research, United Nations HQ, New York, 2012. During the period 2002 to 2003, Mr. Palihakkara functioned as Acting Director General and Deputy Director General of the world-famous Sri Lanka Government Peace Secretariat, SCOP. He was a Commissioner of the Presidential Commission on Lessons Learned and Reconciliation Commission, LLRC, later on. The other his works includes Member, UN Secretary General, appointed Intergovernmental Expert Group on the UN Comprehensive Study on Nuclear Weapons and International Security in 1990 to 1991, Member Panel of Ambassadors advising the UN Human Rights High Commissioner Geneva from 1999 to 2000, Member Governing Council Asian Institute of Technology, Bangkok, 2001 to 2003, Member Board of Directors, Lakshman Kadrigama, Institute of International Relations and Strategic Studies, Colombo, 2006, and Member of Board of Studies of the Bandaranaike Center for International Studies, Sri Lanka. He is married and blessed with one son. Whilst thanking him being here with us today, accepting our invitation, I now cordially invite Honorable HMGS Palihakkara, Governor, Northern Province, to the stage and chair the Defence Plenary Session 2. Sir. Meantime, I would like to call upon to our eminent guest speakers in this plenary. Mr. N. Satyamurthy, Director, Observer Research Foundation, Chennai Chapter, India. Ambassador, retired Sohail Amin, President, Islamabad Policy Research Institute, Pakistan. Major General Noel I. Kar, Director General, Institute for Strategic Studies, Research and Analysis, National Defence University, Pakistan, and Colonel Mohammed Bukta, Commander, Male Area, Maldivian National Defence Force, Maldives. Honorable HMGS Palihakkara will also introduce the presenters of the Defence Plenary Session 2 to the audience. Honorable Governor, over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Vice Chancellor, General Milind Peeris, and all friends and colleagues. I do not plan to go into an introduction because my good friend and distinguished analyst, commentator Rohan Gunaratne gave quite a comprehensive and very insightful introduction to the topic, except to say and congratulate the Vice Chancellor, General Milind Peeris, and his team for organizing this important, timely, and topical discussion on the holistic notion of security, development, and defense, which is not only interesting intellectually, but also has great policy and practical relevance, not only to Sri Lanka, but also to our sub-region, South Asia, and the Asia Pacific, or Indo-Asia Pacific, as it was mentioned here. Given the evolving security, strategic, and geopolitical scenario, evolving not only between states, but within states. After lunch sessions are quite challenging, not least because the attention span is usually not good, but I think the theme is sufficiently exciting, and the panel of speakers we have today, very eminent.